God, unto whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hid. Cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of thy Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love thee and worthily magnify thy holy name, through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
Behold, O God, our defender, and look upon the face of thine anointed. For one day in thy courts is better than a thousand. O Amen.
Who are thy dwellings,
thou Lord of hosts, my soul hath a desire and longing to enter into the courts of the Lord.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Ghost.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end.
Face of thine anointed, for one day in thy courts is better than a thousand. Hear what our Lord Jesus Christ said, thou shalt love the Lord thy God with all thy heart, with all thy soul, and with all thy mind. This is the first and great commandment. The second is like unto it, thou shalt love thy neighbor as thyself. On these two commandments hang all the law and the prophets.
The epistle for today is from St. Paul's epistle to the Galatians, chapter 5, beginning at the 16th verse. I say then, walk in the Spirit, and ye shall not fulfill the lust of the flesh. For the flesh lusteth against the Spirit, and the Spirit against the flesh. And these are contrary one to the other, so that ye cannot do the things that ye would. But if ye be led of the Spirit, ye are not under the law. Now the works of the flesh are manifest, which are these: adultery, fornication, uncleanness, lasciviousness, idolatry, witchcraft, hatred, variance, emulations, wrath, strife, seditions, heresies, envies, murders, drunkenness, revelings, and such like, of the which I tell you before, as I have also told you in time past, that they which do such things shall not inherit the kingdom of God. But the fruit of the Spirit is love, joy, peace, long-suffering, gentleness, goodness, faith, meekness, temperance. Against such there is no law. And they that are Christ's have crucified the flesh with the affections and lusts. Here endeth the epistle.
Thanks be to God.
It is better to trust in the Lord than to put any confidence in man. It is better to trust in the Lord than to put any confidence in princes.
Hallelujah, hallelujah. O come, let us sing unto the Lord. Let us heartily rejoice in the strength of our salvation. Hallelujah.
from St. Luke.
Glory be to thee, O Lord.
And it came to pass, as Jesus went to Jerusalem, that he passed through the midst of Samaria and Galilee. And as he entered into a certain village, there met him 10 men that were lepers, which stood afar off. And they lifted up their voices and said, Jesus, Master, have mercy on us. And when he saw them, he said unto them, Go show yourselves unto the priests. And it came to pass that as they went, they were cleansed. And one of them, when he saw that he was healed, turned back, and with a loud voice glorified God, and fell down on his face at his feet, giving him thanks. And he was a Samaritan. And Jesus answering said, Were there not 10 cleansed? But where are the 9? There are not found that return to give glory to God, save this stranger. And he said unto him, Arise, go thy way, thy faith hath made thee whole. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise be to thee, O Christ.
I believe in one God.
Time slots are 7 p.m. Tuesday night and 10 a.m. Thursday morning. It's the same study both times, so if you can't make it to one, you can try to come to the other. Feel free to drop in whenever you can. If you have to miss a day, you're not gonna, you know, get lost or anything like that. It's not like some college seminar or anything like that. You can pick up. We're doing the same study we did last year. I emailed the notes out to everyone. The Christian tradition, Christian faith in the Anglican Catholic tradition. So it should be lots of fun. Let me know if you have any questions. No food will be provided, but feel free to bring something yourself if you like. 2021 Ordo calendars are now available. They're on the literature table at the parish hall. We ask for a donation of $5 just to offset the cost. You can put the donation in the basket there. Please just take one per family, unless you have a special need. And I will use my Solomonic wisdom to make a judgment. The September newsletter is now available. That's been emailed out to everyone. It's been put online, and we have some hard copies there in the parish hall. 2020 discernment class for the St. Walburga chapter of Daughters of the King is still open. The class will close with an in-person meeting on September 19th at 2 p.m. outside here at the church. If you have any questions or need more information, please contact Christy or Karen. Deacon Mason's ordination is fast approaching. It will be Tuesday, September 22nd at 7 p.m. at the Maryland State Boy Choir Center for the Arts, 3400 Norman Avenue in Baltimore. It's near Morgan State and Lake Montebello in a beautiful residential neighborhood in a gorgeous old church, historic church. Dr. Anthony, as I mentioned many times, is chairman of the board, right?
Yes.
He'll be there. So we'll all be there. So come on out for that. Invitations are on the literature table in the parish hall. A light reception will follow on the patio following the service. Bishop Chad Jones will be the ordaining prelate. So we do have people carpooling from the 8 o'clock service. If someone needs a ride, you can call, get in touch with me and let me know, and I'll try to hook you up with a ride. Karen Novakowski and Christian Knoll, you might not know Christian, he is offered to drive some people as well. So, or if you just kind of don't know where it is, any questions, come see me. It's pretty easy to get to, so don't miss that. And then join Father Waldhauser, the newly minted Father Waldhauser, for his first three masses, the 3 days following his ordination. It's customary for a priest, once he's been ordained, to offer three masses. Votive masses, one for the Holy Spirit, one for the Blessed Virgin Mary, and a mass for the dead. So that will be here at the church Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday that week at 10 o'clock, right, Father?
That's right.
Soon to be Father Deacon. All right, so come on out for that. And I think that's it as far as announcements go. Do I have any other announcements that need to be made? Okay. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost.
Amen.
A Samaritan is the hero of this morning's gospel, just as a Samaritan was the hero of last Sunday's gospel. The points Jesus makes in both gospels would still be there if the heroes were not Samaritans, but the fact that they are Samaritans gives each story some extra bite, because the people who were around Jesus hated Samaritans. Last week, Jesus held up a Samaritan as the perfect example of how to obey God's commandment to love our neighbors as we love ourselves. This week, out of 10 people who have received a miraculous physical healing, a Samaritan is the only one who bothers to thank God. Jesus is on his way to Jerusalem from his home territory of Galilee in the northern part of Israel. As he goes into a village along the road, he sees 10 lepers. The Old Testament had quite a few rules and regulations to cover people who had skin diseases. One was that they were supposed to try to not contaminate other people. So St. Luke reports that the lepers stood afar off. translated into today's language, kind of like a social distance, so we don't get that skin disease. That was the logic behind it. So the lepers stood afar off. From this position, afar off, they yell over to Jesus, "Jesus, Master, have mercy on us." And they're asking him to heal them. What Jesus does not say is almost as remarkable as what he does say. He says, "Go show yourselves to the priests." He doesn't say, "Be healed." He doesn't say, "Ephatha," be open. He doesn't even say, "Your sins are forgiven." He just says, "Go show yourselves to the priests." Telling them to show themselves to the priest is a test of their confidence in him. People with strange skin diseases were not allowed to worship with the rest of the community. When they thought they were over their illness, they had to go get the priest to check them out and then readmit them officially. If they went to the priest before they were actually well, they would contaminate him, which would get them into further trouble. They didn't have a priest at you. That wouldn't be good. So for them to head off to the priest just because Jesus said so showed their tremendous trust in his power to heal them. Their trust was rewarded because, as St. Luke tells us, it came to pass that as they went, they were cleansed. If the story ended right there, it would still have made several very telling points. First of all, the story confirms the idea that Jesus can heal. He has given the same power to the church. We should be as confident today when we ask for his healing power as the lepers were back then. God still heals. Next, we see that Jesus works his miracle through their obedience. They ask him for healing. He tells them what they have to do. They do it, and then they get what they want. Too often, we want God to perform miracles for us when we are not willing to obey him or do our part. We ask him to change the behavior of our family members and other difficult people without involving us in any messy confrontations. We ask for good health while we continue to abuse our bodies. We demand that God fish us out of financial predicaments when we refuse to tithe. The obedience of the lepers sets the proper example. But the story does not end with the lepers' obedience. One of the 10 lepers, who is on his way to the priest, sees that he's been healed. He turns back to Jesus, throws himself down at his feet, praises God, and thanks Jesus for what he has done for him. Jesus asks, "Were there not 10 cleansed? Where are the 9? The only one who's bothered to praise and thank God for what he did was this Samaritan of all people." And then he tells the Samaritan, "Get up and go about your business. Your faith has made you whole." Only a real cynic would imagine that when the 9 got to the priest, they had leprosy all over again, because they weren't properly grateful. St. Luke tells us no such thing, of course. But Jesus is making a significant point about faith in what he says to the Samaritan. Christianity, you see, is all about establishing a relationship with God. And that relationship is called faith. God is our Father. We have confidence and trust that he loves us, and he always forgives us, and that he's watching over us, that he's encouraging us and helping us do the right thing, and that he intends to take us to heaven in the end, where we can see why the events of our lives unfolded as they did. But a relationship is a two-way street. God wants us to thank him for what happens in our lives. He wants us to thank him for the things we like. That way we won't forget where they came from, so we can ask again. but he also wants us particularly to thank him for things we don't like. If we believe that everything that happens to us is something God either causes or allows, then we have to believe that everything, like it or not, fits into his overall plan and makes sense. So to thank God for whatever happens, especially something we don't like or don't understand, is not to deny what we really think, but instead to begin to say, I don't know what you're up to here, God, but I have faith that you are doing something that is ultimately good. So please show me it and help me. The Samaritan liked what had happened, but he still closed the loop by thanking God and Jesus. So he didn't go home thinking he deserved what had happened to him. Instead, his faith had made him whole. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost.
Amen.
honor and glory of God, for all of those on our parish prayer list, those whom we mention in the secrecy of our hearts, and for all the faithful departed in Christ. Rest eternal grant unto them, O Lord, and let light perpetual shine upon them. May the souls of the faithful departed through the mercies of God rest in peace.
Amen.
Pray, brethren, that this my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Father Almighty.
May the Lord receive this sacrifice from thy hands, to the praise and glory of his name, both to our benefit and that of all his holy church.
Amen.
Be favorable, O Lord, to thy people, be favorable unto their offerings, that being well pleased with this oblation, thou mayest give us pardon and grant our petitions. Through thy Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord, who liveth and reigneth with thee in the unity of the Holy Ghost, one God, world without end.
Amen.
Let us pray for the whole state of Christ's Church. Almighty and ever-living God, who by thine holy apostle has taught us to make prayers and supplications and to give thanks for all men, we humbly beseech thee most mercifully to accept our alms and oblations, and to receive these our prayers, which we offer unto thy divine majesty, beseeching thee to inspire continually the universal church with the spirit of truth, unity, and concord. And grant that all those who do confess thy holy name may agree in the truth of thy holy word, and live in unity and godly love. We beseech thee also so to direct and dispose the hearts of all Christian rulers, that they may truly and impartially administer justice, through the punishment of wickedness and vice, and to the maintenance of thy true religion and virtue. Give grace, O Heavenly Father, to all bishops and other ministers, that they may, both by their life and doctrine, set forth thy true and lively word, and rightly and duly administer thy holy sacraments. And to all thy people, give thy heavenly grace, and especially to this congregation here present, that with meek heart and due reverence they may hear and receive thy holy word, truly serving thee in holiness and righteousness all the days of their life. And we most humbly beseech thee of thy goodness, O Lord, to comfort and succor all those who in this transitory life are in trouble, sorrow, need, sickness, or any other adversity. And we also bless thy holy name for all thy servants departed this life in thy faith and fear, beseeching thee to grant them continual growth in thy love and service, and to give us grace so to follow their good examples, that with them we may be partakers of thy heavenly kingdom. Grant this, O Father, for Jesus Christ's sake, our only mediator and advocate.
Amen.
He who truly and earnestly repent of your sins, and are in love and charity with your neighbors, and intend to lead a new life, following the commandments of God, and walking from henceforth in his holy ways, draw near with faith, and take this holy sacrament to your comfort. Make your humble confession to Almighty God, devoutly kneeling.
Almighty God,
Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, maker of all things, judger of all men, we acknowledge and regret our manifold sins and wickedness, which we from time to time most grievously have committed, by thought, word, and deed, against thy divine majesty, provoking most justly thy wrath and indignation against us. We do earnestly repent, and are heartily sorry for these our misdoings. The remembrance of them is grievous unto us, the burden of them is intolerable. Have mercy upon us, most merciful Father, for thy Son, our Lord Jesus Christ's sake. Forgive us all that is past, and grant that we may ever hereafter serve and please thee in newness of life, to the honor and glory of thy name, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Almighty God, our heavenly Father, who of his great mercy hath promised forgiveness of sins to all those who with hearty repentance and true faith turn unto him, have mercy upon you. Pardon and deliver you from all your sins, confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and bring you to everlasting life through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Hear our comfortable words our Savior Christ hath unto all who truly turn to him. Come unto me, all ye that travail and are heavy laden, and I will refresh you. So God loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, to the end that all that believe believe in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. Hear also what St. Paul said. This is a true saying, worthy of all men to be received. Now Christ Jesus came into the world to save sinners. Hear also what St. John said. If any man sinned, we have an advocate with the Father, Jesus Christ the righteous, and he is the propitiation for our sins.
The Lord be with you.
And with thy spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks unto our Lord God.
It is meet and right so to do.
It is very meet, right, and our bounden duty that we should at all times and in all places give thanks unto thee, O Lord, Holy Father, Almighty, Everlasting God. Therefore, with angels and archangels and with all the company of heaven, we laud and magnify thy glorious name, evermore praising thee and saying,
present unto thee, O Lord, ourselves, our souls and bodies,
to be a reasonable, holy, and living sacrifice unto thee. Humbly beseeching thee that we and all others who shall be partakers of this holy communion may worthily receive the most precious body and blood of thy Son, Jesus Christ, be filled with thy grace and heavenly benediction, and made one body with him, that he may dwell in us and we in him. And although we are unworthy through our manifold sins to offer unto thee any sacrifice, yet we beseech thee to accept this, our bounden duty and service, not weighing our merits, but pardoning our offenses, through Jesus Christ our Lord, by whom and with whom, in the unity of the Holy Ghost, all honor and glory be unto thee, O Father Almighty, world without end.
Amen.
Let us pray. And now, as our Savior Christ hath taught us, we are bold to say, Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
World without end.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And with thy spirit.
We do not presume
to come to this thy table, O merciful Lord, trusting in our own righteousness, but in thy manifold and great mercies. We are not worthy so much as to gather up the crumbs under thy table, but thou art the same Lord, whose property is always to have mercy. Grant us therefore, gracious Lord, so to eat the flesh of thy dear Son, Jesus Christ, and to drink his blood, that our sinful bodies may be made clean by
faith in Jesus and remembrance of Christ's life for thee, lean on him in thy heart by faith with thanksgiving. The body of our Lord Jesus Christ, which was given for thee, preserve thy body and soul unto everlasting life. Take and eat this in remembrance that Christ died for thee. Lean on him in thy heart by faith and thanksgiving. The body of our Lord Jesus Christ, which was given for thee, preserve thy body and soul unto everlasting life. Take and eat this in remembrance that Christ died for thee, and beam on him in thy heart by faith with thanksgiving. The body of our Lord Jesus Christ, which was given for thee, preserve thy body and soul unto everlasting life. Take and eat this in remembrance that Christ died for thee, and feed on him in thy heart by faith with thanksgiving. The body of our Lord Jesus Christ, which was given for thee, preserve thy body and soul unto everlasting life. Take and eat this in remembrance that Christ died for thee, and feed on him in thy heart by faith with thanksgiving. Our Lord Jesus Christ, which was given for thee, preserve thy body and soul unto everlasting life. Take and eat this in remembrance that Christ died for thee, and feed on him in thy heart by faith with thanksgiving.
Thank you.
faithful people, and you are also heirs through hope of thy everlasting kingdom, by the merits of his most precious death and passion. And we humbly beseech thee, O Heavenly Father, so to assist us with thy grace, that we may continue in that holy fellowship, and do all such good works as thou hast prepared for us to walk in. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, to whom with thee and the Holy Ghost be all honor and glory, world without end. Amen.
Seek ye first the kingdom of God, and all these things shall be added unto you, saith the Lord. The Lord be with you.
And with thy spirit.
We beseech thee, O Lord, that we who have received the heavenly sacrament may thereby grow in grace to the attainment of our eternal redemption. Through Jesus Christ, thy Son, our Lord, who with thee and the Holy Ghost liveth and reigneth God, world without end.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with thy spirit.
Depart in peace.
Thanks be to God.
The peace of God, which passeth all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of his Son, Jesus Christ our Lord. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost be upon you.